tough one last night for the Astros, who are down 19-15, still comfortably in second place, but a game they felt like they should have won, the Rangers winning in extra innings. Hi, everybody. Welcome. Todd Kallas alongside Jeff Blum. And Blummer, the start to the Silver Boot Series here at Minute Maid Park didn't go the way the Astros wanted. That was a tough one.
That was really an ugly one, to be honest with you. You'd like to be nice about it, but that was not a very good, well-played ball game, even though Michael Brantley tried to get the win for him.
Yeah, Michael did well at the end, but not enough, and the defense, which is normally so solid, let them down at the end of the night. But if you're looking forward to the playoffs, if the playoffs would start today, the Astros would be paired up as the number 6 seed, the second team in the AL West, with the Cleveland Indians.
Actually, looks like a pretty good matchup for the Astros. They've got good pitching and a very good offense to match up with the pitching staff up. The Indians, who have traded away Clevinger, so there might be some weaknesses out there, but I think it looks really good for the Astros if it's ended today.
We don't know about Justin Verlander's health, but with or without Verlander, Framber Valdez is certainly making a case to be one of the top three starters.
I'm 100% with you. I know that when we saw him start to turn the corner a little bit, there were still question marks. Would he be able to maintain this throughout 5, 6, 7 starts? And guess what? Here we are talking about Framber Valdez after his last 6 appearances going, yeah, he would probably be that third starter in a playoff-type situation, even if Justin Verlander was back. He's a nice weapon to have on a left side, and obviously that power breaking ball is what separates him as far as getting the swing and miss.
Earlier you mentioned Michael Brantley. He tried to keep the team in the game, and he's been on a nice roll lately.
Yeah, he's come back from that injury, and again, a lot of hitters use that lower half, but if you don't have that lower half, all of a sudden you're using the upper body and have a tendency to get out of whack a little bit. But he went on the injured list, made sure that quad was right, made sure the ankle and the knee were right, and he's come back tearing the cover off the baseball, driving in big runs for the up on their own. They can't show up together. It is nobody's allowed in the building, so you can't work on anything. You can't throw a bullpen. You can't take some swings. So there might have been a little bit of rust, but also mentally it looked like they were not available last night.
Christian Javier gets the start tonight for the Astros.
Yeah, this is going to be a good matchup for Javier. If he has his good fastball, it's going to be a good evening for him against these Texas Rangers, who are not very good as a ball club against right-handed pitching.
So Javier on the mound, and he will face this lineup for the Texas Rangers and Chris Woodward. Leody Tavares will lead things off for the Texas Rangers. He was down towards the bottom of the lineup yesterday. Isaiah Kinnear-Falefa will bat second. Shin-Soo Chu drops down to the 3 spot as the DH. Nick Solak moves into the cleanup spot. Joey Gallo will hit 5th. They flip-flop spots. Elvis Andrews back at 6th. Derek Dietrich at first base. He'll hit 7th. The rookie Anderson Tejeda has only had 2 games so far in his big league career. He'll bat 8th, and Jeff Mathis, the veteran catcher, will bat 9th for the Texas Rangers. Astros starting defense is presented by Xfinity. Michael Brantley back in left field, and then George Springer on an 85-game errorless streak in center. Kyle Tucker in right field. Aledmys Diaz will get the start tonight at third base after Abraham Toro started there last night. Carlos Correa had his 90-game errorless streak snap last night, hadn't made an error since April 21st of 2019. Jose Altuve at second and Yuli Gurriel over at first. Behind the plate, the machete, Martin Maldonado.
Jose Altuve hitting 3rd, Michael Brantley hitting 4th, Yuli Gurriel hitting 5th, Kyle Tucker hitting 6th, Carlos Correa hitting 7th, Josh Reddick hitting 8th, Aledmys Diaz hitting 9th, Martin Maldonado. Go Astros.
Thank you very much, Frankie. Kids Day here at Minute Maid Park and on our broadcast. So thanks to Frankie, as Colby Allard will face that lineup.
I watched Colby Allard pitch in high school in San Clemente back when I was living in there. He went to school with Sam Darnold, the quarterback for the New York Jets. So a little bit of tie in there with Colby Allard.